Hello and welcome to Poseidwn Tech. This is an electrical store and it is also one of my first KNX installations. KNX was chosen as a future-proof technology and I'm really glad that I made this decision. Now, after so many years, customer called me and asked me. 1. To upgrade KNX with visualization. 2. To add voice control. 3. To create time schedules for the lights. 4. To make integration with other smart devices such as Sonos, Philips Hue lights, etc. Finally, he asked me to be able to make the schedules and integration with other smart devices without having to call me every time that wants to add a smart device. So, to cover his needs, I realized that I have to control KNX using Apple HomeKit or Amazon Alexa or Google Home. The customer is an iPhone user, so for visualization, I decided to use Apple HomeKit. With the Apple HomeKit, you can easily and securely control your HomeKit accessories like Philips Hue, Sonos and KNX. You can turn off the lights, see who's at the front door, adjust room temperature, play music and so much more. For voice control, I decided to use Alexa from Amazon because I like her voice.
Thank you, Theo. Your YouTube channel Poseidwn Tech is amazing.
Amazon Echo Dot is cheap. And also I need a backup solution in case the customer wants a smart device that is not supported by Apple HomeKit. So, having all this in mind, I decided to try 1Home Bridge from 1Home. 1Home Bridge is Apple HomeKit and KNX certified and it also supports Amazon Alexa and Google Home. I have just received 1Home Bridge, so let's unbox it. That is a very beautiful packaging. Inside the box you will find the quick start guide, One Home KNX Bridge. One Home Bridge, it is based on Vinecell's KNX BAU 777. On top you will find the connectors for external power and KNX bus. An Ethernet port in order to plug it in a PoE switch or a PoE adapter. 4 buttons for on-device settings and an OLED display. Finally, an AC patch cord, 2 UTP cables, and a Gigabit PoE adapter from Ubiquiti. Back to the installation. Connect the AC patch cord into power port of the PoE adapter. And into an AC plug. These are the included UTP cables. Here is terminated the Ethernet cable from the electrical cabinet where I will install the 1Home Bridge. So, connect it into PoE port of the PoE adapter. Connect the other UTP cable from a switch or a router into LAN port of the PoE adapter. allow me to tidy up the cables. This is the electrical cabinet with the KNX devices. As you can see, here is the KNX power supply, two actuators from HDL and one actuator from Schneider. Allow me to open the cabinet to see inside. It's not art, but it was one of my first KNX projects, so I'm happy with it. Before I continue, I will turn off the KNX power supply. Here I will install the 1Home bridge. First, connect the KNX bus cable. Finally, connect the Ethernet cable from the PoE adapter. 1Home Bridge is booting. As you can see, an IP address has been automatically assigned to Bridge. So the final step is to turn on the KNX power supply. Now 1Home Bridge is connected to KNX. Let's go now to check the KNX project in ETS. This is my project, so let's open it. This is my project structure. And these are the KNX devices, the switch actuators, and some push buttons. Let's open the group addresses. I have two middle groups, lighting control and lighting control feedback. And here you can see all group addresses. It is really very simple. For example, this group address is for turning entrance lights on and off. And this group address is for the status of the entrance lights. For more details, please watch my KNX programming tutorial. Press the ETS button to go to projects. We have to export the project in order to upload it later in 1Home Bridge. Open a browser and search for 1Home. Open 1Home web page. Go to login. I will log in with my Amazon account. Click on the three lines button. Go to add 1Home box. 1Home Bridge has been discovered, so click on Select. Click on Next. Click on Confirm. Select the ETS project that we were exported before. And click on Upload. Click on Continue. 19 devices have been imported, so let's continue. Here are the devices that were automatically created using the ETS project. Let's check the first device. Click on Gear button. I will change the KNX device type to Simple Light. Let's check if the group addresses are the right ones. The on-off address is correct. And the read address is correct. So, click on Save. Likewise, I will check in the rest of the lights. Now I'm ready to activate all devices. Let's go now to Connected Assistance. Go to Apple HomeKit and click on Connect. Select the room, in my case is the store. These are the devices that will be imported into Apple HomeKit. Click on Continue. It's time now to open Apple HomeKit from iPhone. Tap on Add Accessory. Select I don't have a code or cannot scan. Select 1Home Bridge for nearby accessories. Enter HomeKit setup code that comes with 1Home Bridge. One home bridge was added and here are my lights. Select room for this light or create a new one. I will create the electrical store room. Allow me to take a photo. This one is nice, I will use it. Don't forget to save the new room. I don't want this light to be included in favorites. For now, I will not select a scene. Likewise, I will add in the rest of the lights. So, this is the electrical storeroom with all the lights. It's now time to test it. Let's configure also Alexa. Open Alexa app and tap on three lines button. Select Skills and Games. Tap on Search button. Search for 1Home. Select Enable to use. Login with your Amazon account. Select Discover Devices. Tap on Choose Device. Select the devices that you want to add. That's it. We are ready to try Alexa.
Alexa, turn on ceiling lights. Alexa, turn on decorative lights. Okay. Alexa, turn on desk lights.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on all lights.
Okay.
Alexa, turn off all lights.
So, this was 1Home Bridge from 1Home. My thoughts about this device is that I really like it. The whole procedure was very easy, and as you watched in this video, I used the device in a real installation and I covered my customer needs in less than an hour, which is really amazing. More capabilities of 1Home Bridge will be revealed in the next episodes. So, stay tuned.